Hey, everybody, what is going on? Siri Love Jav here, and today we're going to be going over how to break into Arasaka Industrial Park the easy, stealth, and violence-free way. And this is in the game Cyberpunk 2077. So to break into Arasaka Industrial Park, what you're going to want to do is go to this far entrance here where there's this big dude guarding the entrance. He's a little scary, but don't worry about him. First things first, shut off the security camera because they're just bullshit. You don't want them bugging you. Distract the guard, then you sneak in, just holding to the right. Hug that right corner. You're gonna come up to a camera right here. I'd recommend turning this off. You don't actually need to, but I just turn it off just in case something goes wrong. Once you get that camera off, you're gonna find sort of off to your right. So off to your right, there's gonna be this big metal tank. You can jump on top of this tank, and this is without any sort of implants or anything like that. Get on top of this tank, get onto this little platform here, and you see this door right here? Just go right through it. One thing of note, once you go through this door, there is gonna be a sniper on the other side. So do it with a little bit of stealth, a little bit of finesse. Don't just go barreling in there like some big boy, right? All right, anyways, drop down. Now off to your left, there's gonna be a platform that you can sneak under. This is a pretty safe place to go, so you can just hide under here for a little bit, get your bearings, figure out what's going on. But once you've got all of that figured out, what you're gonna wanna do is go straight, sort of hanging off to the left. Hang off to the left until you get to the other side of the, you know, the industrial park or the hangar, whatever you want to call it. There's going to be this sort of like float right here. You're going to want to get on top of this float, and the way you're going to do that is using a lift. So there's going to be a lift. You go up the lift, jump on top of the lift, then jump on top of this float. Do note off to my right here, there is this sniper. So, you know, pay attention to him. Don't distract him. Yeah, don't get his attention, okay? Then you're going to jump on top of the very sort of tallest part of this float. You're going to disable this camera right here. Again, disabling the cameras just makes things a lot easier. You're going to go here, and now you're going to be seeing your goal. This is the float that you want to get to. So you jump on top of this. You're sort of on top of everything. A lot of these guards just don't really know how to look up. A few of them do, though, so just keep an eye out. Every now and then you're going to see someone spotting you. Just go back behind cover when that happens. This is sort of a kill-free, violence-free method, so it's tricky. Anyways, drop down. You're going to be able to get behind this float. Yeah, now there's another float here. This is actually the one you want to go. I misspoke. So there's a float right here, so you're going to want to just time it so you can walk past all these guards. There is going to be one sighting, but once you get behind that guy, you're sort of good to go. He's not going to come investigate. So just sort of book it right over here. Get behind this guy. You're going to be right here. This is a float that you need to get into. What you are going to notice about this float is if you go to the front, there is a guard standing directly in front of the entrance. So now the way that you're going to want to do this, the way you're going to want to not alert this guard, not deal with all the bullshit of distracting him and everything like that, is to jump onto another lift platform here. So it's going to be parked against the wall. You jump on top of this, and then you can get on top of this platform right here. If you've got double jump, you can just jump on top of it. You get in through this window to the float, and now you can go do your thing with that computer. I'm not going to spoil it, so there's going to be nothing here that you guys can see. Once you're done doing all your magic, you're going to jump back onto that platform that we were using before, and now you do have to distract this guard. So distract the guard, and what you're going to want to do is, again, hugging the left, you're going to jump on top of all these sort of platforms, right? These shelves. You're just going to keep jumping on top of them. Stay as high up as you can, and keep an eye on this guard, because if he does sort of turn around, it's going to be a bit of a problem, right? He's going to see you. There's going to be some shooting. It's not the stealth way. In this game, I'm like role-playing the character that's just all stealthy, and he doesn't want anyone knowing that he got in to sabotage this float. So there's no violence, no shooting, nothing like that that's going on in my playthrough here. That's why I'm not killing anyone. My character is definitely not a pacifist, but in this instance, it just makes sense. It's what a good role player would do. So once you get to those platforms, you jump onto this platform here. This is going to lead to the roof. It's going to get a little sketchy. There's going to be some people that notice you. Things are going to be going wrong. All you've got to do is push forward. Just push, push, push forward. They will not see you as long as you can push forward fast enough. Now, I'd argue that this is actually a problem with the AI, but, you know, I'm not CD Projekt Red. I'm not the developer in charge. I'm just taking advantage of what I see. Anyways, you jump to the roof, you're good to go, and that is that. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, hit the like, hit the sub button, because guess what? There's going to be a lot more of these videos where this one came from. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I'm not going to waste your time. Until next time, peace.